This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Dennis Michael Lynch, born August 28, 1969, is an American businessman, documentary filmmaker, political commentator, and former host of Dennis Michael Lynch, Unfiltered, which aired on Newsmax TV currently. He is the founder and CEO of TV360 Media, a company specializing in the production and distribution of digital film contents. 1. Early Life. 2. Career. 21. Business. 22. Films. 23. Politics. 24. Television. 3. References. 4. External links. Early Life. Lynch was raised in Hicksville, New York. After graduating high school, he went on to attend the John Jay College of Criminal Justice at the City University of New York, as well as various other colleges, but did not graduate from any of them. Career. Business. In 1991, at age 22, Lynch launched a computer recycling company called Lynx Technologies. Lynch grew Lynx to become one of the largest computer hardware companies on Long Island. In August 1999, Lynch secured $13 million from venture capitalists and John Sculley, the former CEO of Apple and Pepsi. In less than a year, Lynch expanded the company to 300 employees and 5 locations across the country, and renamed it TechSmart as a result. In 2000, he was selected as the winner of Long Island's Ernst Brinkley, Alec Baldwin, and Ed Burns, and it premiered at the Hamptons International Film Festival 2010. In 2012, Lynch released a film about illegal immigration and the impact it has on America, They Come to America. Written and directed by Lynch, it premiered in New York and was well received by local media. However, the film did not secure theater distribution. Lynch claims distributors rejected the film because it places an American face on the issue and touts numerous illegal aliens, stating they do not wish to be American citizens, and that they come to the U.S. solely to earn money during appearances on shows like The O'Reilly Factor, Fox. In February 2013, Lynch announced he would not seek theater distribution for the film, and he was accelerating the release of the film because he felt it could help stop the immigration reform bill S-744 crafted by 8 senators led by Sen. Charles Schumer D. and Marco Rubio R. The film was set for release on April 16, 2013, but Lynch delayed the release because of the bombings that took place at the Boston Marathon on April 15. Lynch revised the film to include the Boston Marathon bombings and released the documentary on April 26, 2013. On May 11, Lynch appeared on the Fox News program American HQ. He stated, "Only Fox News will grant me interviews and show clips of my film. The mainstream media will not grant me interviews because they don't want the truth to be shared." On July 4, 2013, Lynch appeared on a special episode of Hannity titled This Cost of Amnesty, in which he, Sean Hannity, and other guests discussed Lynch's latest movie They Come to America 2, The Cost of Amnesty, as well as the recent passage of the Senate immigration bill S-744, Terrorism, and Unemployment, in an interview on Fox. The documentary on DVD. Lynch's fourth film is based on the book Power Grab, Obama's Dangerous Plan for a One-Party Nation. The book is written by New York Times best-selling author Dick Morris. In the film, Lynch interviews Morris about the last 2 years of President Barack Obama's term in office, about how Morris believes Obama will try to complete his fundamental transformation of America. The film was released on Newsmax TV in February 2015. Politics. On October 24, 2014, Lynch announced on the Kelly File that he was exploring the possibilities of running for president in 2016. On April 17, 2015, Lynch was one of 19 presidential hopefuls to speak at the Republican Leadership Summit in New Hampshire. A few weeks later, on May 5, 2015, Lynch announced he would not run in 2016. Television. On January 16, 2016, Lynch started hosting the news and commentary program Dennis Michael Lynch, Unfiltered on Newsmax TV. The program features investigative reporting, interviews, and commentary with a heavy emphasis on user interaction through social media. However, on August 10, 2016, he was cut off after he announced that it was his final show and was fired by the Newsmax TV management after his criticism about his own news network, as well as his defense of Fox News. Lynch stated that in his fighting for Trump on his show, his message had been restricted. However, J.D. Hayworth disputed Lynch's claims about Donald Trump, saying that Lynch was not embracing the truth and was engaging in self-censorship. References. Carrot Founder. 12 September 2012. Lynch official website. Personal blog at TheyComeToAmerica.com. VE 2012. Primary vote pairing Democratic Party political positions endorsements debates and forums primaries results superdelegates convention polls national statewide straw candidates VP nominee Hillary Clinton campaign. Endorsements positions VP nominee, Tim Kaine other candidates Jeff Boss Harry Braun Lincoln Chaffee campaign Rocky De La Fuente Paul T. Farrell Jr. Keith Judd Lawrence Lessig campaign Martin O'Malley campaign Bernie Sanders campaign endorsements. Positions Sam Sloan Michael Steinberg Vermin Supreme Jim Webb campaign Robbie Wells Willie Wilson John Wolfe Jr. Republican Party debates and forums endorsements primaries results convention polls national statewide. Straw candidates VP nominee Donald Trump campaign endorsements primary positions protests Republican opposition VP nominee, Mike Pence other candidates Jeb Bush campaign positions Ben Carson campaign Chris Christie. Campaign Ted Cruz campaign endorsements positions Mark Everson Jack Felyer Carly Fiorina campaign Jim Gilmore campaign Lindsey Graham campaign Mike Huckabee campaign positions Bobby Jindal campaign. John Kasich campaign endorsements Josue LaRosi Dennis Michael Lynch Andy Martin Jimmy McMillan George Pataki campaign Rand Paul campaign positions Rick Perry campaign positions Marco Rubio campaign positions. Rick Santorum campaign Scott Walker campaign Libertarian Party debates and forums primaries convention candidates nominee Gary Johnson campaign endorsements positions VP nominee, Bill Weld other candidates John McAfee Austin Peterson. Robert David Steele Vermin Supreme Green Party debates and forums primaries convention candidates nominee Jill Stein campaign endorsements VP nominee, Ahamu Baraka other candidates Daryl Cherney Constitution Party primaries convention candidates. Nominee Daryl Castle campaign VP nominee, Scott Bradley other candidates Tom Hofeling Joe Miller Independent Better for America Evan McMullen campaign endorsements Mindy Finn. American Party of South Carolina Peter Skews American Solidarity Party Mike Maturin America's Party Tom Hofeling Nutrition Party Rod Silva Party for Socialism and Liberation Gloria La Riva VP nominee Eugene Puryear Peace and Freedom Party Gloria La Riva VP nominee Dennis Banks other candidates Monica Moorhead Jill Stein Prohibition Party James Hedges Reform Party Rocky De La Fuente VP nominee, Michael Steinberg other candidates Darcy Richardson Socialist Equality Party Jerry White Socialist Party USA Mimi Soltysik campaign VP nominee, Angela Nicole Walker Socialist Workers Party Allison Kennedy VP nominee, Osborne Hart United States Pacifist Party Bradford Little Veterans Party of America. Chris Keniston Workers World Party Monica Moorhead Independent Candidates Lawrence Kotlikoff Not on Any Ballots Dan Bilzerian Waka Flocka Flame Zoltan Istvan Terry Jones John McAfee Merlin Miller Deez Nuts Guy Schwartz Ron White Ted Williams These candidates are constitutionally ineligible to serve as president or vice president.